Hey students, in this video we are going to look at how we can factor a trinomial that's in standard form. And so we have been multiplying binomials and the answer that we end up with has looked like this. 2x squared plus 5x plus 3. But now we're going to work backwards to figure out what the two binomials were that we multiplied to get this answer. And so that's called factoring. And so we're gonna always start with a trinomial that's in standard form. So it should look like this, where the leading term is the squared term, and then we have our middle term, it's just x, and then the last term is just a constant without a variable. And we don't have to worry about this GCF because we didn't talk about it in class, but we are going to use a method called slip and slide. And this is a four-step process, and I'm gonna guide you through those four steps in the video. And so if we look at the standard form equation, right here we don't have any numbers, we just have letters that represent the numbers. So A, B, and C in my trinomial down here are all numbers. So the value of A is 2, the value of B is 5, and the value of C is 3. So for step number one in our process to start factoring this, we want to slip the A, so we want to take the A term and we want to slip it to the end of the trinomial and multiply it by whatever C is. And so let's go ahead and do that. In my first example, the 2 is my A and the 3 is my C, and according to the slip and slide method, I want to take this number and I want to move it to the end, and I want to multiply it by the 3. And so that will create a new trinomial that's going to be a kind of a more basic trinomial where the first term doesn't have a number in front of it, no coefficient. And so now step two, I want to take this new basic trinomial and I want to factor it. But in order for me to factor this, I'm gonna have to use the diamond method that we talked about in class yesterday. And so that's where we are going to utilize the skills that we learned yesterday with the diamond problems. And for this, the number that goes in the top of the diamond is gonna be the 6. Because that's the number that we multiplied the A and the C together, or we slipped the A to the C and multiplied it. Now, the number that goes at the bottom is gonna be the middle term, which is 5. And so just like yesterday, we need to figure out what are two numbers that I can multiply to give me 6 and I can add together to give me 5. And so yesterday we looked at doing our little factor tree. So we know it's 1 times 6, and we also know it's 2 times 3. And only one of these factors is gonna give me 5 when I add them together. And that's gonna be 2 and 3. So if I put on the sides of my diamond here, I have my 2 and my 3, because again, 2 times 3 is 6, and then 2 plus 3 is 5. Now here it says to factor this using that information. So when we say factoring, we're going to place those numbers inside parentheses like this, as though we were writing two binomials. So I know that I can take x plus 2 and then x plus 3. Now, this is not our final answer, because step 3 says that we need to divide both of these factors by the number that we slipped over. And so the number that we slipped over was 2. And so since I multiplied 3 by 2, I'm gonna have to divide both of these numbers by 2. So let's do that. I'm gonna divide this by 2, and I'm gonna divide this by 2. Now step 4 tells us to reduce the fractions. So here I have a fraction 2 divided by 2, and I have another fraction 3 divided by 2. And step 4 tells me I need to reduce the fractions. If I cannot reduce the fractions, then I'm gonna slide any denominator over to the variable. And so I'm gonna show you what I mean. So in this first binomial, we can reduce this fraction because 2 divided by 2 is 1, so that just becomes x plus 1. But in my second binomial, I can't reduce this fraction. If I type 3 divided by 2 in the calculator, it stays 3 divided by 2. So instead, I'm going to take this denominator and I'm going to slide it over and it goes in front of the x. So 2x plus 3. And this answer is now considered my factored form. So, and when we say a factor is like the 2 and the 3. These are factors because I can multiply those together to get 6. Well, this x plus 1 is my factor, and this 2x plus 3 is my factor, because if I multiply those together, I will get this back. And I'm actually going to show you that in just a moment. So let's see, let's actually check it, and let's see that that works out. So this is the work that I explained earlier, and now I want to take that factored form and I'm going to remultiply it out using the box method to see if I get this answer back again. And so I've already set this up. You don't have to set this up. You can if you want to on the back side of your notes, but you don't have to set this up on the front side. And we already know what to do here because we've been doing this for a while now. And so we can see that the information that's in the box, when we bring that down and we combine our like terms, we get 2x squared plus 5x plus 3, which is what we started with. So these two binomials, when we multiply them together, the result is equivalent to what we started with. So this is the factored form of this standard form trinomial. So let's try another one. So let's look at this one. And again, we want to do the same thing because this we're going to use the slip and slide method. So I want to take the 5 and I'm going to slip it over to the 6 and multiply. So m squared minus 17m plus 30, because that is what I get when I do 5 times 6. Step number 2 is I want to factor this. But in order to factor it, we have to do our little diamond problem that we looked at yesterday. So 30 goes up top, and then negative 17 goes at the bottom. And this is where you'll have to determine what are factors of 30. So we have 1 and 30, we have 2 and 15, I have 3 and 10, and we have 6 and 5. And as I look at these factors, I know that the 30 is positive and the 17 is negative. So that means both of these factors are going to be negative here. So negative 1, negative 30, negative 2, negative 15, negative 3, negative 10, negative 6, and negative 5. And no, we talked about this yesterday. If you were absent, then I understand you might be a little lost, but we did this yesterday in class. So if I go through and add these numbers together, only one of the factors is going to give me negative 17, and that's negative 2 and negative 15. So I'm going to put that here, negative 2, negative 15, and negative 2 times negative 15 is positive 30, but negative 2 plus negative 15 is negative 17. So I'm going to use those two numbers here to do my factoring. So I make my binomials, and I have m minus 2, and I have m minus 15, because I'm just using these numbers here in my diamond problem. So here's minus 2, and here's minus 15. So that's step number 2. Step number 3 says, hey, now you need to divide those factors by the number you slipped over, which was 5. So let's do that. I'm going to divide this by 5. I'm going to divide this by 5. And then step number 4 says to reduce. If I can reduce the fractions, reduce it. If you cannot reduce the fractions, slide the number over to the variable. So can we reduce 2 divided by 5? No. So I'm going to take that 5 and I'm going to slide it over to the m. So 5m minus 2. Can we reduce the 15 divided by 5? We certainly can. Divide that in your calculator if you're not sure, but 15 divided by 5 is 3, so this is m minus 3. And so this answer is now considered my factored form. And what we're going to do is we're going to multiply this together just to check that, hey, it actually works out. So flip your paper over and then you can do the multiplication on the back side because it's blank. So if we look at the factored form that we have here, and on this side, I wrote down where I'm going to check it. And we've already done this in class, so this is not anything brand new for us because we've done this for a week now. I'm going to do 5 times m, and we know that we're going to get 5m squared. I do 5m times negative 3, we get negative 15. So we get these numbers by multiplying on the outside. And we know that our middle terms here, the negative 15m and the minus 2m, we're going to combine those to negative 17. And this answer or this product is the same as what we started with. So this factored form is equivalent to this standard form. I'm gonna do one more example. So I'm gonna start you off with number 3 and let's see how well we do. Now that we don't see the steps. First, we know that we're gonna take this 6 and we're gonna multiply it by the 4. So we're gonna slip it over. So that'd be y squared minus 5y minus 24. And then, that's where we're going to do our diamond problem. So we can write the factor for step 2. So I have negative 24 because that is the number, the last number. And then negative 5 is the number that we have at the bottom of our diamond problem. And so yesterday we looked at, well, what are the factors of 24? So if I take 24 and factor it out, I have 1 times 24. I have 2 times 12. I have 3 times 8, and we also have 6 times 4. Now, yesterday we talked about some numeracy strategies. So if this top number is negative, that means one of these numbers is negative. But if the bottom number is negative also, that means the bigger factor has to be negative. So when I write this out, negative 24, negative 12, negative 8, and negative 6. Because when I add them together, that's going to be negative only if the bigger number is negative. So which of these numbers is going to give me negative 5? Well, hey, that's going to be 3 and negative 8. So I know that this can be 3 and negative 8. And I'm going to use those two numbers to factor this out, do a basic factoring. So I have y plus 3 because my 3 is positive. And then I have y minus 8 because my 8 is negative. But remember, according to step 3, I need to divide 3 and to divide 8 by 6. So I'm going to take this divided by 6, this divided by 6, and then we're going to reduce our fractions. And if we can't reduce, we're going to slide the number over. So I can reduce the 3 divided by 6, and that's actually 1 divided by 2. And we can also reduce the 8 divided by 6 as well. Because 8 and 6, you can divide 2 from both of those. This is going to be 4/3. If you're not sure, just put that in your calculator and it'll give you 4/3. So unlike the other ones, we don't want to leave this as a fraction. Since we can't go any further, now I can take this 2 and I can slide it over. And I can take this 3 and I can slide it over. So my answer is going to be 2y plus 1 and then 3y minus 4. And so this is considered my factored form. And I will leave the checking to you to verify that, hey, this is the same as this. So I want you to try example 4. And then I also want you to try number 1, number 2, and number 3. And then I'm going to insert the work in this video because I'm running low on time. And so I'll be around the classroom to check that out as well. And when you're finished, there's a little coloring activity for you to do where you're going to write the factored form using this slip and slide method, and then the color corresponds